Welcome, friends, at the Wellfish Bay Community Church's service. Online service, though, we are still not able to gather, and we will not be able to gather for the next couple of weeks, but we are able to get together on this social platform. So we want to say welcome to everybody that's listening, watching this message from wherever you are in the world. Friends, let us please pray for everyone, everybody that is radically affected by COVID. We have seen so many tragedies this last couple of weeks, and it's times like these that some of the things that we can do is to seriously pray for one another. I also want to thank everybody that's making a contribution to our ministry. We really appreciate it, whether it's financial or with food items. Everything is welcome in these times. Friends, before we start, let's pray together. Father God, we want to thank you again for this opportunity to be gathered in this way. And we pray, Holy Spirit, that you will speak to everyone that is listening this day. We pray that your word will be alive to us, that we will hear your promises anew, and that we will grow in our faith. Thank you that we can pray this in the mighty name of Jesus. God, we want to pray for everyone that is affected by COVID. We all feel it. It's close to all of us. We pray for those that lost family members. We pray for those that's in hospital at the moment. We pray, God, that recovery will be speedy. We pray, God, that you will touch the lives of people that's affected and their families. In Jesus' name we pray this. Amen. Friends, so this morning we are going to read a story from the Old Testament, and it's from 1 Samuel chapter 30, verse 1 to 6, and then we are going to look at a couple of promises from God. Let's read together. Now, when David and his men came to Ziklag, on the third day, the Amalekites had made a raid against the Negev and against Ziklag. They had overcome Ziklag and burned it with fire and taken captive the women and all who were in it, both small and great. They killed no one, but carried them off and went their way. And when David and his men came to the city, they found it burned with fire, and their wives and sons and daughters taken captive. Then David and the people who were with him raised their voices and wept until they had no more strength to weep. David's two wives also had been taken captive. And David was greatly distressed, for the people spoke of stoning him, because all the people were bitter in soul, each for his sons and daughters. But David strengthened himself in the Lord his God. Friends, this is a very interesting story. So David and his men were off, and they were fighting battles. And when they came back to the city they lived in, their wives and sons and daughters were taken captive. And we read that they wept until they could weep no more, until they had no strength left. And then David was in distress because the people wanted to stone him because he was the leader and they wanted to blame him for what happened. But then we read this stunning verse in the Bible, but David strengthened himself in the Lord. So what did he do? David looked at the promises of who God is. David thought about everything that happened in his life. Instead of trying something else, instead of trying to flee or bargain with his men, he strengthened himself in the Lord. Friends, and this is exactly what we need to do in a time like this. We live in unprecedented times. Usually, friends, I lead a funeral about once every 5 weeks. In the last 2 weeks, I had to lead more than 5 funerals. We are all experiencing the reality of loss in different ways. The challenge is not to get gripped by fear, disbelief, and discouragement. That's the challenge. It's not to get gripped by fear, disbelief, and discouragement. Because for us as children of the living God, there is a greater reality. Why? Because God has not changed. His character remains the same. His love is steadfast and His promises are still true. Today we are going to remind ourselves about God's promises. We are going to strengthen ourselves in the Lord our God. So friends, let's look at a couple of promises. And they haven't changed because God did not change. He's still the same God. He's the same God yesterday, today, and forevermore. What's one of the promises that we can strengthen ourselves with? Well, let's look at the first one. The first one is we belong to a family that helps one another. We belong to a family that helps one another. John 17, verse 21 says, I pray that they may all be one. This is Jesus that's praying for us. I pray that they may all be one. Father, may they be in us, just as you are in me and I am in you. May they be one, so that the world will believe that you sent me. Friends, Jesus prayed this beautiful prayer for the church. He prayed three things in the verses that we read. He said he prayed that we will be one. That means that we will be in unity. He prayed that the church will be like a family that's there for one another. And then he also prayed that we will be one with him and with God. And thirdly, Jesus prayed that the world will believe because of our unity. What a beautiful prayer. Friends, in the church, we are supposed to share love. We are supposed to help one another. And let me tell you, I've seen this over the years. I've seen how the church reach out to one another, how they love one another. And I'm seeing it today more than ever. Friends, this is a time of ridiculous generosity. The times we live in now should be known as times of ridiculous generosity. This is the time for us to reach out to one another. This is not even though we're in isolation. This is still, it's still possible for us to reach one another in love and with help. This is the calling of the church because, friends, we belong to a family that helps one another. And I hope that you find courage in it and in the prayer that Jesus prayed. Secondly, we can take this promise from the Word of God that we are not alone. We are not alone. Hebrews 13, verse 5 and 6 says the following, For God has said, I will never leave you. I will never abandon you. Let us be bold then and say, The Lord is my helper. I will not be afraid. What can anyone do to me? Friends, God said he will never leave us and he will never abandon us. That's one of the promises that we can take in this times. God will still be with us. We are never alone. I know that sometimes it feels like we are battling this, we are fighting this fight on our own. But God says he will never leave us. He will never abandon us. And that's why we can boldly say, The Lord is my helper. I will not be afraid. Friends, we've all been asked to practice social isolation. And it's for a good reason. But isolation in the midst of a pandemic does not mean we are alone. It does not mean we are alone. Instead, we know that not only do we have the cloud of witnesses, the people that went before us, but we know that we have one another. We are not alone. And we are there for with prayer for one another, and we have the power of the Holy Spirit with us to give us courage. So that's a second promise from the Word of God. We are not alone. because God has not forsaken us. Let's look at a third promise. Third promise from the Word of God is that God will sustain us. God will sustain us. Acts chapter 17, verse 24 to 28 says the following. God, who made the world and everything in it, is Lord of heaven and earth and does not live in temples made by human hands. God is the one that made everything. He made the heavens, He made the earth, and He does not live in temples made by human hands. Nor does He need anything that we can supply by working for Him, since it is He Himself who gives life and breath and everything else to everyone. Just listen to this verse. This is what the Bible promises. It is not us that is sustaining God, but it is God that is sustaining us. And we receive from Him life and breath and everything to everyone. In the next verse we read, from one human being He created all races of people and made them live throughout the whole earth. He Himself fixed beforehand the exact times and the limits of the places where they would live. He did this so that they would look for Him and perhaps find Him as they felt around for Him. Yet God is actually not far from any one of us. As someone has said, in Him we live and move and exist. In other translations it says, in Him we live and move and have our being. Friends, this we can remember, and we should remember this promise of God, and we should strengthen ourselves by this promise. God will sustain us. No matter what happens, no matter how the story ends, God will sustain us. He is the one that is there for us. Through Him we live and move and exist. Even if things go terribly wrong on earth, we know that God will sustain us in every circumstance. And God will sustain us for all eternity. That's the third promise. Let's look at another promise. Jesus said that He has overcome the world. Jesus said He has overcome the world, and we read about that in John chapter 16, verse 33, where it says, Jesus is speaking, I have said these things to you, that in Me you may have peace. In the world you will have tribulation, but take heart, I have overcome the world. Friends, I read a story about a church and a community in Nigeria which were attacked by the Islamic terrorist group Boko Haram. The pastor of the church is called Reverend Marcus. And when these attacks happened, people were killed, churches were burned, houses were destroyed, and lives were changed forever. And yet, Reverend Marcus lived in the knowledge that Jesus overcame the world and that nothing can defeat them as Christians. And so when they prayed after these attacks, he said, we do not pray that God will take away the hardship, but that God would give us the grace to be able to stand. Isn't that wonderful? We do not pray that God will take away the hardship, because Jesus said, in this world, we will have tribulation. We will have problems. We will have troubles. But take heart, Jesus said, I have overcome the world. So, God, don't take away the troubles. Give us the grace to be able to stand. That was their prayer. So Reverend Marcus explained it, and he said, the Bible tells us that whoever endures to the end will receive a crown of righteousness. And this is the message that they want to send into the world. We have to endure. We can take heart because Jesus overcame the world. Friends, and let me ask you this morning, do you live from this promise where Jesus said, take heart, I have overcome the world? Even if you face opposition, even if you face many troubles, know this, I have overcome the world. God, we pray that you will not take away the hardship, but that you will give us the grace to stand. Friends, regardless of the situations for Christians, Jesus reminds us that he has overcome everything the world can throw at us. Because of that, we can have confidence and hope no matter what happens. While this can be hard for our minds to comprehend in light of current times, we only have to look at the example of our persecuted family to see this kind of faith in action. So, whatever we are facing, let's pray this same prayer. Another promise from the Word of God says that through Jesus we are more than conquerors. We read this in Romans 8, verse 35 and 37. It says, "Who shall separate us from the love of Christ? Shall tribulation, or distress, or persecution, or famine, or nakedness, or danger, or sword?" No, verse 37, no, in all these things we are more than conquerors through him who loves us. Friends, isn't this an amazing, amazing testimony? Who shall separate us from the love of Christ? What can happen in our lives that can separate us from the love of Christ? Problems, distress, persecution, famine, a pandemic, nakedness, danger, weapons? The answer is no. We are more than conquerors through him who loved us. What a wonderful promise that we can hold on to in this day. No matter what we face, we can know that we are more than conquerors because God loved us so much. And nothing can separate us from the love of God. Let's look at another promise. Nothing can separate us from his love. There's absolutely nothing that can separate us from his love. Same chapter in Romans, Romans 8, verse 38 and 39 says, "For I am certain that nothing can separate us from his love." I want you to say this morning. Nothing can separate me from God's love. This is the promise. No matter what you're facing, nothing can separate you from the love of God. Neither death, nor life, neither angels, nor other heavenly rulers or powers, neither the present nor the future, neither the world above nor the world below. There is nothing in all creation that will ever be able to separate us from the love of God, which is ours through Jesus Christ our Lord. Did you hear that, friends? Not death or life, angels or heavenly rulers, powers, not what's happening in the present or in the future, what's happening in the world above us or in the world below us. There is nothing in all creation that will ever be able to separate us from the love of God, which is ours through Christ Jesus our Lord. Will you say it with me this morning? Nothing. Say it again. Nothing. Say it one more time. Nothing. Friends, say it until you believe it. Nothing can separate me from the love of God. Nothing can separate me from the love of God. I don't know what is your fear right now at this moment, what you are worried about, but you can know this. Nothing can separate you from the love of God. Let's look at one last promise. God is our refuge and our strength. This is what David knew when his men wanted to stone him, when they lost everything they had, including their, their wives and their children. David knew God is our refuge and our strength. Psalm 121, verse 1 and 2 says the following, I lift up my eyes to the hills. From where does my help come from? My help comes from the Lord who made heaven and earth. Friends, when we want to look up at the hills, when we want to look up at the mountains, and we say, where will my help come from? To whom should I turn? The answer is, my help comes from the Lord who made heaven and earth. If he was able to make the heaven and the earth, friends, then he is able to be our refuge and our strength. So strengthen yourself with this promise. Strengthen yourself with this word. If you feel lonely today, if you feel stressed, if you feel worried, why don't you say this to yourself? My help comes from the Lord. My help comes from the Lord. Say it until you believe it, until you feel it in every bone and every fiber of your being. My help comes from the Lord who made heaven and earth. Friends, we are going to listen to a song. The song is from Christian Stanfill, and it's called Always. I want you to look at a verse and the chorus of the song. He wrote this song and he said, troubles surround me, chaos abounding. Maybe that's exactly how you feel today. But my soul will rest in you. I will not fear the war. I will not fear the storm. My help is on the way. My help is on the way. Oh my God, he will not delay. My refuge and strength always. I will not fear. His promise is true. My God will come through always. Always. So friends, let's close by listening to this beautiful song, and then I'll just say a prayer for us.
I will not fear.
Father, we want to thank you for these words. We know that when trouble surrounds us, when chaos is abounding, our souls can find rest in you. And we declare this morning, we will not fear the war. We will not fear the storm because our help is on the way. We want to say this morning, oh my God, you will not delay. You are our refuge and strength always. We will not fear because your promises is true. Our God will come through always. Thank you, God. I pray that your promises will fill us this morning, will lift our faith in the name of Jesus Christ. And God, I pray that we will be light and salt to the earth around us with our faith and our trust that is fully, fully in you. In Jesus' name we pray this. Amen. Thank you, friends. May you have a wonderful day today. May you have a wonderful week. Next week we are going to talk about fear and faith. And I'm inviting you to come and join us again. May you be blessed.